Transmission gates are nothing but a PMOS and an NMOS connected in parallel to each other. This is my PMOS and this is my NMOS. They are both connected in parallel to each other, and this is my input and this is my output. So what it does is, suppose if my P logic is 0, both of them will have the same input. Say, let's call this input A. So if A is 0, this is going to be A bar, which is equal to 1. So both my PMOS and NMOS would be on at the same time, and it passes my input to the output without degrading my input. What do I mean by degrading? It's nothing but, as we saw in pass transistor, that NMOS cannot pass a perfect 1 and PMOS cannot pass a perfect 0. When both of them are connected in parallel and both of them are given an input which is complementary to each other, we get output equal to input without any voltage drop, or in simple words, we get an output which has a perfect 0 or a perfect 1. And this is also one of the symbols to represent the transmission gate. In all my clips, I'm going to refer to this symbol. So both means the same, so there's nothing to worry. Let's go ahead and see the last style, and that's nothing but clogged CMOS, also very commonly known as C square MOS. In C square MOS, we have the pull-up circuit comprising of PFATs or PMOSes, similar to static style, and we have pull-down circuit comprising of NMOS, similar again to static style, but in between my pull-up and pull-down circuit, I would have two more transistors operating on clock. For pull-up, this is my pull-up, I will have a PMOS because pull-up always has PMOSes. And for my pull-down, I will have NMOS. And both of them operate on clock, but one operates on phi, another one operates on phi bar. So what happens is, both of them, if phi is equal to 0 or phi is equal to 1, when my NMOS transistor turns on, my phi bar is equal to 0. So both of this will become closed switch and it behaves same like static style. Why do we need to use this? Because it has its own advantages, which we have seen in the previous clip. In nutshell, in this clip, what we have understood is, in static style, we saw a pull-up comprising of PMOSes and pull-down comprises of NMOSes, but number of PMOS equal to number of NMOS, which used to increase our area. So we went to the next style called zero NMOS, where we reduced the number of PMOSes by just one, but it had its own problems. So we went to dynamic, in which the pull-down network was same like zero NMOS and static CMOS. However, we included one footer transistor additionally in the pull-down network, and we also had a pull-up network which was not always on, but a PMOS which was connected to a clock signal phi. It had its own problems like monotonically rising inputs, so we went to the next style, which was nothing but domino style. And domino style is nothing but a dynamic circuit followed by a static inverter. Then we quickly went ahead and saw pass transistor, but it had its own drawbacks of producing a degraded output. So we went ahead and saw a transmission gate where a PMOS and NMOS is connected in parallel to each other. And we finally ended up seeing a clock CMOS or a C square MOS logic circuit, in which the pull-up comprises of static CMOS plus an additional PMOS transistor operating on clock, and a pull-down network comprising of NMOSes plus an additional NMOS transistor operating on clock complementary to PMOS. Now, using this general pictorial diagram, we'll be studying different combinational circuits, sequential circuits, and even some of the basic gates. Hope you have understood. Stay tuned. Thank you very much.